Hello and welcome to Kim Reacts. I'm Kim and today we're going to watch the episode 36 of Fairy Tail. And shout out to my patron for supporting this channel. And also, if you want to be a part of that, please do check my Patreon page in the link in the description down below. And there you will have an early access to all of my reaction videos. And please like this video if you enjoyed watching it. And also subscribe to my channel if this is your first time here, so you'll be updated whenever I upload my Fairy Tail and other anime reaction videos. And without further ado, let's start watching this episode and see what we have. Yeah, so last episode, he wore the costume of the cat. But and also the daddy guy is also here. But I guess he'd be able to notice that. Oh, a new intro. Wow. And this is a mid-arc opening. Because usually they introduce new openings whenever there's changes in the arc. Hope this isn't too spoilery, but I guess maybe not. Because so far, the openings haven't been that spoilery. We only seen much of the what their enemies gonna look like. But the story is still kind of vague, so I guess that's kind of different. Oh, Mary Jane! I'm excited to see that. I guess that's kind of spoilery. But I'm kind of surprised because it isn't the end of the arc yet. They're just going to fight. Or maybe this overarching story. Maybe this will just end temporarily. This now Urza is kinda. Oh, it's a different title song. Maybe it's. Oh. I think. Yeah, what about Lucy? Yeah, because Urza mentioned that Natsu is the one Natsu is the one who will surprise Urza. I think the master kinda. Oh, Miliana, stop. Oh, yeah! Will this be an internal conflict between Lian and the dandy guy? And that's just playing the role. So maybe if the mask. Oh, he's burning. Oh, now she's pissed. Oh yeah, she's the one who tied up Lucy. But Urza wanted to prevent this from happening because they were just also tricked by Jeral. But they're kind of good that they were able to restrain. Natsu, but I guess he's still not going full power. Happy. Just a stupid thing that he decided to put on. Oh yeah, what is that? Oh, it worked! And she's kinda cute though. And it's a good thing that she's not on the bad side. They're both not. And
what
And yeah, I think Natsu was just playing around. I wonder how powerful Zeref is in this form, because he was once a very powerful, famous wizard. And who's this guy? I'm not sure if one of the kids that Erza has been when they were slaves. So they need Erza as a sacrifice. So maybe her right eye, I think, has something to do with the right eye of Gerald with Zeref. Who are these? Oh, so he hired. Go to hell. Or maybe they were Zeref's previous minions, but I guess that would have been too long. So maybe he hired a guild. Oh, they're not wizards, they're assassin. Assassin's guild. Or maybe that's just the name of their guild. They're still trying. Oh yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah, he did immediately. Oh yeah, he was kind of playing a game. It's like he wanted to. It's like a leveling up on the tower. Battle Royale. Oh, he knows about Aetherian. How did he know? So that's Siegfried. So it's possible that Siegfried and Jellal is working together. But how did Siegfried know about? So maybe Siegfried and Jellal met before and he knew about Zeref? Guess now they. I think that's a bad idea. It should be better if they would stick together. Even though it's a battle royale, they can still work together to defeat the three warriors that Jellal summoned. Just now they realize that Jellal was just playing them. Yeah. So these guys might become a part of Fairy Tales. And they're great wizards as well. So he approved now of Natsu because of his scarf. Oh, one of the three warriors. Oh, the owl. Ah, screeching sound. Oh, yeah. I'm not sure if Natsu believes. We'll believe that. Oh, maybe he's just buying time. Maybe he's just buying time to complete the preparations. So maybe they're working together. I'm still having some doubts against Siegfried. Oh, he's an owl. He can see in the dark. Yeah, he's the perfect opponent of this guy. Oh, one of the dark guilds. So they are mages. And the turf lap. Oh, yeah. Maybe he has a. Yeah. So maybe they have a dirty technique that will put Natsu disadvantage. But they have been able to defeat Dark Guilds, Dark Guild before. Oh wait. It's kinda cool though. It's like how Natsu's using the flame in his feet. He's using its other boosters. So he's... So maybe he knows something about... Maybe Natsu is also a part of the... Because he's one of the ancient... He's using ancient magic. Oh... And she's seeing Gray in a differently. It's like she's it's like a shoujo anime. Oh, maybe they're fighting the rockstar guy. But good thing Lucy is with one of the elements for. And she has! I forgot Leo. Hope she'd use Leo now, because she just used Virgo for now. So maybe this guy is about sound, magic. But this kinda pretty loud for an assassin. Oh, she isn't faced by that. She is one of the elements for. Misheard luck for her. Will it be just that just easily? Oh, he is absorbing the water to use it. But he's there. So he's like the perfect counter for Juvia. Oh. Oh, he's like that, huh? So Lucy has to step up. But if he, so maybe he'll now be able to control Juvia. Yeah. And I remember that Juvia was able to capture. Oh, I hope Leo will come out now. Okay, so that was the end of the episode, and it's crazy that Juvia was defeated like that, but I guess that this is the opportunity for Lucy to use her skills, because she was able to summon, but I guess it was just a short time that she was able to summon all of her celestial spirits. But now that she has Leo, I think Leo could, I guess Leo is still depending on the mana of the wizard, so, but I think now Lucy could be able to summon Leo, and I think Leo is one of the most powerful zodiacs. He's not just a rare golden celestial key, so he's also one of the leaders, I think, of the zodiac. So I'm excited to see that on the next episode, and also that the Jellal summoned this, I guess he kind of hired them. They're hired mercenaries, assassins from the Assassin Guild, Dark Guild. And they also talk about the award happened before. So maybe that will be also played out in the future. But what I'm kind of worried about is Siegfried and Jellal's relationship, because I feel like Siegfried is planning something. They're planning. I'm having doubts about him, because it's like he pushed through the Aetherian immediately, But I guess it makes sense that he wants to destroy the Tower of Heaven immediately, affecting other civilians or other, because it will destroy a country just by the strength of the magic of Ethereum, and he wanted to push it through. So wonder what his motives are, because maybe it isn't what we are seeing right now. Maybe he has a deeper purpose, because Jelal knew about it, he was expecting it, and he is kind of, and he's buying time. That's what I'm worried about. So it seemed like he's wanting for the Ethereum to destroy the island, the Tower of Heaven, or maybe one of the requirements to create the resurrection is to use to absorb a powerful magic. So I'm not sure about that, but it's kind of worrying, because if he knew that Ethereum will be used on the Tower of Heaven, he should be not wasting time. He should just take Urza and use her as a sacrifice, so he could continue with the resurrect, and then the three warriors will protect him or the ritual from happening. But right now he's just buying some time to let them fight, and then before, after that, the last, because it is a battle royale, so only one will be left, and then that's the one I think who will get Urza or who will fight him. So why does he have to do that? So I kind of worried that he's buying time for the Ethereum to be launched, and he will use that to his advantage for the Tower of Heaven to be used, I'm not sure. But Urza is one of the sacrifice that will be used for the ceremony, and I think it has something with her right eye, because when she was used as a sacrifice and when Jelal saved her, there's something wrong with Jelal. Is that something that, what's happened to your eye, you know, something like that. So how about you guys, what are your thoughts on this episode? Just leave a comment down below, and if you have any feedback about this video, any suggestions, just let me know, and please like the video and subscribe to my channel if this is your first time here, so you'll be updated whenever I upload my fairy tale reaction videos and other anime reaction videos. And also please check my Patreon page, there's an early access test there for my reaction to episode 37. It's now available there, so please check it out, and thanks for watching, and see you in my next reaction video. Goodbye.